Service of marriage. celebration in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Not only are Matthew and Glory Press welcoming God to join them as one in marriage today, but they are also forming a family with their parents, Mr. and Mrs. Gary and Linda Wong, Mr. and Mrs. Press and Flory Nalo, with Yen Yen, and the rest of these two fine families. And just as it is appropriate that they have a lay for themselves, they also wish to show just how much they loved you and appreciate you with the gift of a lay. Hearts full of joy to overflowing, we gather in this significant moment, giving thanks to God and waiting in anticipation for your promises you are about to make, Matthew and Glory Press, that you intend to speak to one another in our witness. But just to make sure we all know exactly why we're here, and for all who are gathered here in person and are gathered wherever they are around the world virtually, I have a question for all of you. And that question is, will you uphold and care for Matthew and Flory Press in their new lives together? So I invite you to answer wherever you are and in a way that can be both heard and believed. Will you please all answer, we will.
We will.
I believe I heard that. And I believe that. Let us pray. Gracious God, you sent your Son Jesus Christ into the world to reveal love to all people. Enrich Matthew and Flory Press with every good gift, that their life together may bless us all and give glory to you, our Heavenly Father. Amen. You have selected two readings to focus us for this big day. The first reading is from Paul's letter to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. Thank you, Matthew, for selecting that reading.
And now, Florida Crest, your selection to focus our hearts is from the letter of 1 Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Matthew and Florida Crest, you made it. With the arrival of your wedding day, the traditional part of me is just dying to cry out to the church down the aisle, hand in hand. But you have truly outdone even that. If there is a more glorious place on the planet to be wed, I don't know where it would be. We gather here in the cathedral of God's natural grandeur. In this most beautiful world, the temple of existence our God has made. And no, Matthew, I am not talking about the star on the 50-yard line of Cowboy Stadium. It is into this glorious setting at Turtle Bay, Hawaii, and the moment of your wedding that the two of you have arrived. And of course, we have too, gathered either in person or virtually. We are here and solidly behind you. And not only that, if it weren't enough to be joined by those you love and who you love and who loved you the most on your wedding day, the very best part is that God is here too. And that, what was most essential to both of you, that your wedding, your coming together, be a sign of faith and hope and love. Now, of course, there's all that other stuff too. Important stuff, like how to get to know each other when your lives were spread out over two Californias, SoCal and NorCal. You figured that out. Then there's those other things like getting to know and earn the respect of family and friends, the sorting of careers, the blending of histories, the sharing of traditions, the understanding of values, the planning of a wedding. And you've done a nice job with all of that too. The key for you both though was this, that what we're doing here today be of God, that your beginning be planted in the good soil of your shared Christian faith and tradition, because that is who you are, who you were raised to be, along with all the other values and teachings and commitments formed in you over the years. And all of this in you is just waiting to declare, I do. But let's not go too fast, shall we? Well, maybe you'd like to go a little faster, but we need to revel a little in this splendor. It is good and right for us to enjoy life when it's good. Weddings are incredible moments, actually. Moments when we remember and know deep down that we come from somewhere. That there are fabulous particularities. And I want you to hear that right. I'm saying particularities, not peculiarities. Particularities to being a Hwang or a Nalam. All of this, the significant stories, joys, challenges the two of you and your families have faced together, ready you, Matthew, and you, Florida Crest, to be formed by your promises today. Yes, this union, both of you becoming one, is being planted in good soil. The very best kind that yields quality and results in abundance. I see it also in the Bible verses that each of you chose for your wedding. Matthew, yours from Philippians, and yours, Flory Crest, from 1 Corinthians. Two different books from the New Testament, but really with a very similar ring to them. For the common denominator of these readings is a desire for faith, for hope, and for love to actually be lived out. That these aren't just high and mighty concepts, but aspirations for daily life. You chose these lessons, I believe, because you want your lives to be gentle and true, honorable and just, pure and pleasing and commendable, full of excellence, and the kind of love that bears and believes, hopes and endures. So I'd say you both want a lot out of what's happening today. And you are right in doing so. You want this marriage to reflect your faith, and you want it to be a testament of the best of who you are and what you value the most. Matthew and Flory Crest, what you seek is ambitious. And it is also admirable. And we all support you in this endeavor. Now, we all know that every union will face its share of twists and turns. There will be difficulties and there will be challenges. But if you stay true to this aspirational beginning and to a mutual course of respect, forgiveness, and love, God be praised for who you together will become. Heaven knows you've had great role models to look to in this. The ones above you and beside you, they're cheering you on. It's all possible because God loves to do new things. Grace us with new beginnings. Redeem and restore, forgive and resurrect. God loves a Genesis. The creation of something new. So much so that the first book of the Bible is actually named Genesis. And how does God do it? Well, we can only surmise, really, but what I think it is that God loves to take a work of ours and make something grand, beyond all expectations, out of it. And here's what God has to work with today. The two of you, of course, where you've come from, all your prior formations and commitments, but also, and most significantly, your words, your promises to one another. We call them wedding vows. By your promises, God binds you together and makes you one. Not in a way that loses all that came before, but rather has the opportunity of taking you, who you are, to its highest and best use. You, Matthew, and you, Flory Crest, brought together and joined as one. You have been blessed to become a blessing, to give and to receive, forgive and celebrate. You were called to love one another and be there for each other today, tomorrow, and forevermore. And that's the as long as we both shall live part of the traditional wedding vow. But that's not even the whole of it. Because as the reading from 1 Corinthians that you chose, Flory Crest, succinctly and eternally says, love never ends. Your words are about to change everything forever. For the better. And that's why we're here, and why this pastor needs to stop talking. Because we're here to hear from you. All of us ready to rejoice, and our God, in whom we place our full hope and trust, ready to create something new. Amen. And so, Matthew and Floribess, if it is your intention to share with each other your joys and sorrows and all that the years will bring, with your promises, bind yourselves together as husband and wife. You give her your flowers. Join hands and face each other. Matthew, you will go first with your vows. Please repeat after me. Floricress, I take you.
Floricress, I take you.
Oops, I'm going to move this way. We'll start over again here. Floricress, I take you.
Floricress, I take you.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
From this time onward.
From this time onward.
To join with you.
To join with you.
And to share all that is to come.
And to share all that is to come.
To give and to receive.
To give and to receive.
To speak and to listen.
Speak and to listen.
To inspire and to respond.
To inspire and to respond.
And in all circumstances.
And in all circumstances.
Of our life together.
Of our life together.
To be loyal to you.
To be loyal to you.
With my whole life.
With my whole life.
And with my whole being.
And with my whole being.
And now you, Floricress. Matthew, I take you.
Matthew, I take you.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
From this time onward.
From this time onward.
To join with you.
To join with you.
And to share all that is to come.
To share all that is to come.
To give and to receive.
To give and to receive.
To speak and to listen.
To speak and to listen.
To inspire and to respond.
To inspire and to respond.
And in all circumstances.
And in all circumstances.
Of our life together.
Of our life together.
To be loyal to you. With my whole life.
With my whole life.
And with my whole being.
And with my whole being.
All right. May I have the rings, please? All right. You start with Tyler over here. He's going to help you. Great job, EJ. The wedding ring is an outward and a visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying the uniting of this man and woman in holy matrimony. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings. May they who wear them live in love and fidelity and continue in your service all the days of their lives. Amen. Matthew, if you would please take Floricress's ring and repeat these words to her as you place it on her finger. Floricress, I give you this ring.
Floricress, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
Floricress, if you take Matthew's ring. And repeat these words as you place it on his finger. Matthew, I give you this ring.
Matthew, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
And now may I have the coins. These coins, I'm going to move this back, sorry. These coins traditionally have represented the promise that Matthew to support Floricress and Floricress's dedication to Matthew. But today, more than this, it represents that Matthew and Floricress are united in love and harmony For Matthew and Flory Crist, these coins represent that their love and dedication to each other will be the true prosperity of their marriage to each other. So now, promise that you will love and support each other for eternity. Please repeat after me. Again, Matthew, you first. I think you repeat first. You repeat the lines first, yeah. I, Matthew, promise you.
I, Matthew, promise you.
That I will love and support you.
That I will love and support you.
Forever.
Forever.
Flory Crist. I, Flory Crist, promise you.
I, Flory Crist, promise you.
That I will love and support you.
That I will love and support you.
Forever.
Forever.
In exchanging these coins, Matthew and Flory Crist are vowing their undying devotion and support to each other. As we witness their acceptance of these coins, we also witness their willingness to be blessed with each other's company, with each other's dedication, and to always be there in heart and soul for each other in good times and bad. Matthew and Flory Crist, you have just sealed your relationship by the giving and receiving of rings and coins. This is a pledge between two people who agree that they will commit themselves to one another throughout their lives. Today, this relationship is also symbolized through the pouring of two individual containers of sand, one representing you, Matthew, and the other one representing you, Flory Crist, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated, our prayer for you today is that your lives together would be blended like the seven seas, and that your love shall swirl around each other like the changing tides. If you would go over to the sand. All right, receive the blessing. Let us pray. Faithful God, source of love, pour down your grace upon Matthew and Flory Crist that they may fulfill the vows that they have made in steadfast love and faithfulness to each other. Use us to support their life together, and from your great store of strength, give them power and patience, affection and understanding, courage and love, that they may continue together in mutual growth all of their days. Gracious Father, you bless the family and renew all people. Enrich husbands and wives, parents and children more and more with your grace, that strengthening and supporting each other, they may serve those in need and love what you have made. Finally, we ask your special blessing on this young couple, praying the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Matthew and Flory Kress, by their promises, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife. By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. I think you should hand this off because, Matthew, you should and may kiss the bride. turn and face them just a little. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Matthew and Flory Kress Wong, husband and wife. Ha 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 ha!